This innovation involves either integrating developing artificial technologies with existing infrastructure or designing architecture around AI systems. There is a lot of excitement in this field, influenced in part by Mark Zuckerberg's personal project to develop networked AI systems within his home. His wish is to develop simple AI systems to run his home and help with his day-to-day tasks. This technology would have the ability to recognize the voices of members of the household and respond to their requests. Designers are taking on the challenge of designing home-integrated systems, such as the Aura system of responsive furniture, or gadgets such as Alexa for energy monitoring. Banas Farai is an example of a young architect who is employing her research into AI and adaptive surfaces to develop interactive designs, such as in her Aurora and Breathing Wall projects. She creates immersive and engaging indoor environments which adapt to and learn from their occupants. Like an increasing number of practices, she is engaging with AI, experimenting with integrating it and applying it in different ways in her work. Researchers and designers working in the field of AI are attempting to understand the potential of computational intelligence to improve or even upgrade parts of the design process, with an aim to create a more functional and user-optimized built environment. It has always been the architect's task to make decisions based on complex, interwoven and sometimes contradictory sets of information. As AI gradually improves in making useful judgments in real-world situations, it is not hard to imagine these processes overlapping and engaging with each other. While these developments have the potential to raise questions in terms of ownership, agency and, of course, privacy in data gathering and use, the upsurge in self-learning technologies is already altering the power and scope of architects in both the design and construction phases. Currently, many AI algorithms are still relatively uniform, and it is proving difficult to automate decision-making that would at first glance seem simple for a human mind. A number of research labs, such as the MIT Media Lab, are working to solve this. However, architectural language and diagramming have been part of programming complex systems and software from the start, and they have had a significant influence on one another. To think architecturally is to imagine and construct new worlds, integrate systems and organize information, which lends itself to the front line of technological development. As far back as the 1960s, architects were experimenting with computer interfaces to aid their design work, and their thinking has inspired much of the technology we now engage with each day.
Because of the complexity of the situation and because of the way software is going, software that was designed to do that could very rapidly take the world by storm. You've probably heard the sort of, you know, it's a sort of familiar thing in the history of the development in technical change. Very often, the people responsible for a certain specialty are then followed by a technical innovation, and then the people that are responsible after the technical innovation is a completely different group of people. For instance, I mean, this is the old saw, you know, the people who built the buggies for the horse and buggy did not then turn into Henry Ford. Henry Ford and the people that were building automobiles came from left field and then took over, and the horse and buggy died off. It is conceivable to imagine a future in which this problem of generating the living structure in the world is something that you would explicitly recognize as part of your responsibility.
Click the top left screen to go back to the beginning and discover how artificial intelligence is changing site research, or skip to parts 2, 3, or 4.